Good morning, family. I was informed by my sister in Christ yesterday that we've got to keep all of our brothers and sisters in Christ. We're getting attacked. I mean, we're definitely close to the rapture. I pray more of the world wakes up and sees that. We got Gator, 1111, prayers for his health and a speedy recovery. And also Tony Lamb. He said that he was, I'm reading the message I was sent. He said that he's been getting attacked. His neighbors have been vandalizing his home and shooting at his home. So we need to pray in Jesus' name for his protection and for an end to all of that. So put on the full armor of God. We're closer and closer to the rapture. I've been saying that the closer we get to the rapture, the more the attacks are going to escalate. I can tell as soon as I woke up today, it's going to be a bad breathing day for me. We have this issue with the house. Don't know what's going on. I'm going to see if our homeowner's insurance covers it. I don't think they're going to, but, you know, it doesn't hurt to try. We got the plumber coming over again, and this plumber calls my mom. He's a close friend of the family's, and so he wouldn't steer us wrong. And he said that, you know, he's going to give it a shot. He's not expecting really anything to happen. But he walked up and down the length of the road, he said, to see the sewer line and check out the sewer line. He said, this is a city issue. And the fact that my neighbor's having the same problem, the city hasn't fixing it. So at this point, I'm going to call Channel 5 News. Channel 5 News will come out here and investigate it, you know. So, yeah, we can't use the shower. We can't flush the toilets, so we can't use the toilets. We can't run laundry, so... I'm with my daughters. I wanted my mother to come over here with me, but she's set in her ways and she wants to be in her own bed. So she's got a porta potty. And I just asked her if she was okay. She said she's okay. So I don't know what Tom's gonna do. I said it'd probably be better if you have a family member or friend to stay with, you know, until this is fixed, because we can't use the bathrooms, you know. So, we're getting attacked, and a lot of brothers and sisters are getting attacked, like, one after another after another. We've got to be close. I'm praying it's before the video's over. So, put on the full armor of God, family. I'm sure you do. Matthew 24. Verse 44 says, therefore, you also must be ready, for the Son of Man is coming in an hour you do not expect. First Timothy 4, verse 1, now the Spirit expressly says that in latter times, some will depart from the faith by devoting themselves to deceitful spirits and teachings of demons. We see this happening right now. One, people supporting Joe, you know who. False prophets. I don't want to say any names, but my grandson just came in. Say hello.
Yes.
You spoke to Jesus the other day, didn't you?
Yes, you had it so proud.
What did Jesus say?
Jesus said it back home.
He keeps saying that. He keeps saying that. Was he happy?
Yeah.
What did he look like? Did you see him? He's pointing to the sky. Wow. He's coming back for us soon.
Yes.
He keeps saying back home. Is he taking us back home?
Yes.
There's a lot of them. False prophets out there, like Joel, you know, Leo.
I too.
Is that what you think of false prophets?
Yeah, I stinky.
Leo. I'm sorry, guys. Leo. Is that what you... He's sticking his butt up. Leo, come on, I'm trying to do a video. there's a lot of them out there, you know, like Joel, you know who, and, but, you know, there's a day coming where everybody answers to God. Yeah, I tell my daughter all the time, you know, Jesus is returning soon. That's why all of this is happening. That's why all of this is happening around the world. It's sad that people still don't see it, you know, but there's a lot waking up to it. All hell is about to break loose around the world. Before World War III officially breaks out, the restrainer, us, we will be raptured. So it could happen anytime. This is from One News 247. I don't have a computer. I haven't just used my Android phone. With the Android phones, you go up to those three dots on the screen and you hit it and just click translate. It pops up immediately. South China Sea war zone. Chinese have attacked a Philippine ship with knives. Ships destroyed and sailors injured. And they got a video. U.S. deployed typhoon system. Will defense treaty with Philippines be triggered? The U.S. has unexpectedly deployed the Typhoon missile system in northern Luzon, L-U-Z-O-N, in the Philippines, following violent naval incidents between China and the Philippines, Philippine Navy. The U.S. Deputy Secretary of State emphasized that the mutual defense treaty the U.S. has to help the Philippines, sending a very clear message to Beijing. The level of aggression shown by the Chinese this time has alarmed all the neighboring states. That's horrible. My prayers go out to the victims and the families of the victims. Newly released, and this is an X tweet, and they got a video here. Wow. You know, some have said that when this country gets attacked, it's going to be like a Red Dawn incident. Just, you don't want to be here for what's about to happen in this world. I know times are tough. Believe me, I know times are tough. We're literally using the bathroom in buckets right now. But you know what the good news is? We have so much to look forward to, and we're not going to be here much longer. So hang in there. I know you guys are. No, don't. Sometimes we don't understand why, like, we pray and certain prayers don't get answered right away. I was praying as I was looking at this water that was gushing over that pole, you know, that's in our yard, and just praying that it would get unclogged, and it didn't. But I know God's in control, and I know everything will work out. I'm almost wondering if there's like, if like a squirrel or something went in there. I don't know. But yeah, newly released footage shows the moment Chinese Coast Guard boats surrounded and boarded a Philippine Navy vessel in the South China Sea. Who videotaped it? A Filipino sailor lost a thumb in the confrontation. That's just horrible. Hey, stop. This is our territory, a Filipino soldier shouted as China Coast Guard used physical force, weapons, sirens, and bright lights to prevent our AFP from delivering supplies during a humanitarian mission at BRP Sierra Madre in the Philippines on June 17th. Savage Chinese attack with knives and axes. Oh, God bless them. New battle code. They're vicious, man. China's vicious. They are vicious. A clash between members of the Chinese Coast Guard and members of the Philippine Navy occurred on Monday during a resupply mission for Philippine soldiers. I guess it's already Monday there. Stationed on the sunken BRP Sierra Madre military ship in Second Thomas Atoll. In the videos, you could see the Chinese Coast Guard's use of force and intimidation tactics destroyed Philippine vessels and seriously injured Philippine Navy personnel. Wow, this is horrible. The Philippine Navy released photos showing Chinese Coast Guard personnel wielding knives, swords, spears, and axes. Oh, God bless them. And other sharp implements. Oh, boy. Threatening to injure Philippine troops during the supply mission. This world is about to explode. I mean, we're in borrowed time. We're so close to the rapture. It seems that China wants to establish a code of fighting similar to that on the border with India. While there is an agreement not to use firearms, but only bladed weapons. Shocking new details and video showed that during China's brutal attack on the Philippines, Chinese Coast Guards deployed tear gas in an act of piracy. Chinese personnel looted supplies. Oh, this is just demonic. There's so much evil in this world. Towed Philippine vessels with ropes. The Chinese ships came within 5 meters of the Philippine outpost. The Chinese personnel were armed with knives and axes. They reportedly used these weapons to rip apart parcels carrying food and medicine supplies, throwing the contents into the sea to an attempt to revert. Oh, Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, bring us home. We got a lot of videos here. Apparently, Chinese claimed that it was Philippines who provoked. Yeah, right. Philippines who provoked CCG during the recent incident at Second Thomas Shoal. But below is a video clearly depicting three CCG ships harassing a small Filipino coastal vessel. Yeah, they lie. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos said his country will not allow itself to be bullied after a clash between members of the Chinese Coast Guard and members of the Filipino Navy. Quote, we will never allow ourselves to be intimidated or oppressed by anyone, end quote. So here's another war about to break out, said President Marcos in a speech he delivered. I'm going to have to get my nebulizer out today. On the occasion of his visit to... I got to sit up. I can't lay down like that. Forces in the South China Sea. However, he stressed the importance of settling dispute in a peaceful manner. In the performance of our duties, we will not resort to violence or intimidation, nor will we intentionally cause injury or damage to anyone, he stressed. In defending our nation, we will stay true to our Filipino nature, whereby we would like to resolve all these issues peacefully, added the Filipino president, who did not name China during his speech. That's awesome, you know, but here's the thing. China, they're demonic demons out there, and they're horrible, and they're nasty, and they are not going to work out peace. I commend him for trying to handle this peacefully, but with China, it's not going to happen, you know. Beijing's actions during this routine resupply mission were condemned by the U.S., Britain, and Canada, so here's another war breaking out. I've always said 2024 is sticking in my head, and I don't know why. And I've always felt that as all the wars happen and all the bombs drop, we go up. So China's... One second, I'm sorry. China's foreign ministry disputed the Filipino version, with a spokesman saying on Thursday that the necessary measures were taken were legal, professional, and beyond reproach. Not only are they demonic, but they're stupid, too. Wow. I'm sorry. Bad breathing day today. China claims almost all of the South China Sea, through which more than $3 trillion in annual shipping trade passes, including parts claimed by the Philippines, Vietnam, Indonesia, Malaysia, and Brunei, B-R-U-N-E-I. The Hague-based Permanent Court of Attribution ruled in 2016 that China's claims lack legal basis being rejected. Beijing rejected this decision. Well, of course, they're gonna. Will the U.S.-Philippines Defense Treaty be activated? U.S. Assistant Secretary of State of East Asian and Pacific Affairs Daniel Crittenbrink said on Saturday that the situation in the South China Sea is deeply troubling. Sorry, just 1 second. And that China's recent actions in the disputed waterway are deeply destabilizing. Crittenbrink made the comments during a visit to Hanoi amid rising tensions between China and the Philippines in the South China Sea, where Vietnam is an additional player in the region. We believe that China's actions, particularly in recent actions around the Second Thomas Shoal, including a disputed maritime area towards the Philippines, have been irresponsible, aggressive, dangerous, deeply destabilizing. I agree. We will continue to stand by our Philippine allies. Kritenberg said, adding that Washington had made it clear, both publicly and privately, to Beijing that its mutual defense obligations to the Philippines were unwavering. U.S. Defense Deputy Secretary of State Kirk Campbell discussed China's actions by phone with his Philippine counterpart, Maria Lazaro. Both agreed that China's dangerous actions threaten regional peace and stability. Campbell reaffirmed that the 1951 Mutual Defense Treaty, which Washington and Manila, with Washington and Manila, to assist each other in defending major attacks, extends to armed attacks against Philippine armed forces, public vessels, or aircraft, including those of the Coast Guard anywhere in the South Sea. And they're saying right now this defense treaty can now be triggered at any time with unpredictable consequences. The new Chinese law, which took effect on Saturday, empowers its coast guards to seize foreign ships illegally entering China's territory waters and detain foreign crews for up to 60 days. The law renewed a reference in the 2021 legislation that says China's coast guards can fire on foreign ships if necessary. As it turns out, the defense treaty can now be triggered at any time with unpredictable consequences. Taipei welcomes the U.S. deployment of the Typhoon system in the northern Philippines, a top Taiwanese official said here this week. From the Philippines, the American missile system can extend a safety net to Taiwan as well. This development is potentially a problem for China, as the system can launch... Sorry, just one second. Had to pause the video. Missiles with a range of 2,400 kilometers and anti-ballistic missiles linked to the AEGIS system. The Typhoon system could hit Chinese warships from a long distance, while with the use of the RIM-174 ERAM Standard Missile 6, it could contribute to the defense capabilities of American cruisers equipped with AEGIS. As to comment on the missile deployment, a Taiwanese official stressed the importance of maintaining a free and open in Indo-Pacific without anyone trying to unilaterally change the status quo using armed force in violation of international norms. Anyone who can collectively protect this area should be welcome. The Philippines and the U.S. have launched major military exercises in the region. Man, all hell's about to break loose for real. We got wars all over the world. I'm not going to say 100%, but there's a good chance the rapture could happen this year. I mean, if it doesn't happen, we're still going to look up and keep our lamps lit. Because I'm going to be looking for y'all at the marriage supper. I love you guys. We're brothers and sisters in Christ. You guys mean so much to me. If you only knew how much your prayers and how much all the help you've given me has helped me. Just thank you doesn't seem like enough. I mean, I cannot wait to meet you guys in heaven and give you guys a big hug. I wonder what food's going to be at the marriage supper. Y'all ever wonder that? I mean, it's got to be brownies. I can't wait. I'm ready to leave. You know, I don't want to be here anymore. I want to go home. And, you know, a lot of people, when we mention the rapture and we talk about Jesus returning, they a blank stare. Like yesterday, when I made the video yesterday, I was talking to my neighbor. And I mentioned the rapture. He was giving me a blank stare. He gave no comment. A blank stare. And that's really sad, you know? I mean, can you imagine what Noah went through? He's telling everybody there's going to be a flood and it never rained. All we can do is just keep warning people. And plant seeds. We want as many on the boat as possible. And we're going to pray for our brothers and sisters that are being attacked. Thank you for your prayers and for Tony Lamb, Gator 111111, pray for them. And hang in there, family. Time's short. I know I keep saying that, but it really is. I can feel it. I just feel like any second we could be raptured. Don't y'all feel that? It's like we just have that feeling like any second we're going to be raptured. And my grandson's 3. He's just learning to talk. And he keeps saying, back. And now he said back home. So hang in there. And thank you for your prayers. I do still have Venmo, Cash App, and PayPal. I got a lot of doctor's appointments next week, and I was told this was good insurance, and it's not. Every time I turn around, they're charging me for something else. I get another bill in the mail, a lab bill, or you know, for blood work, and that the doctor I saw what is he called now, pulmonologist. So what's going on? Here's my breathing. I'm going to refer you to this for this and this. Okay, $60. And I'm like, you literally did nothing. Wow. So, I do have the links. And I know the rumor mill is going to be flying, but you know what? They can answer to God. You don't know what somebody's going through, you know? I mean, I have my nanny job that I'm starting August 1st that I intend to start. So I got to get better, you know? So keep looking up, family. Keep listening. And I will see you at the marriage supper. God bless.